are again, dinner time. So I'm gonna cook some veggies and I just wanna show you what I'm making. And I've decided to do a quick video and use my phone versus using my camera, so I hope you're okay with that. I'm mixing a medley of vegetables together. I've got cauliflower, which I've cut up, which we're gonna have. And I've got some broccoli, which I've cut up. And I've got some zucchini squash that I've also cut up. And I'm going to add some onion. What's nice about these vegetables is there's no carbs. And because we have been doing the keto diet, I must admit, I've lost 30 pounds in 3.5 months. Got a ways to go, but I'm getting there, don't you know? So anyhow, I'm gonna cut up some onion because we do like that. And onion's gonna go in with the veggies. What I traditionally do to help speed up the process, as well as to make sure the vegetables are not crunchy, I don't like them real crunchy after they're cooked, is I take the broccoli and I take the cauliflower, and I do like to put it in the microwave for about 2 minutes. It just softens it for me so that it cooks easier when I saute it, and it's not so crunchy when the medley of vegetables are done. So we're gonna go ahead and get this over into the microwave. And I'm gonna just do 2 minutes. I don't add any water. All right, and we're just gonna do it for 2 minutes. Get that started. Now I'm gonna get my cooking utensils out so that I can get started. I do have my favorite skillet. I have a nonstick coated skillet that I like. And let's get that fired up. And I usually just put it on high just to get it warmed up. And I like to cook myself with coconut oil. Coconut oil is better for you than olive oil. And it doesn't burn as fast as you see olive oil, or excuse me, coconut oil. Coconut oil does not burn as quickly or as hot as olive oil. So I like to use my coconut oil. So let me get my little spatula out of here and we'll get some into my cooking utensil. And we don't need a whole lot. It doesn't take a whole lot. So anyhow, I've got my oil in my skillet here. And I also like to add a little butter because butter just gives off flavor. And I do like to use real butter. We don't use margarine, we use real butter. And I like the salted real butter. So I'm gonna put that in there as well into the frying pan. I've still got it on high as I want the oil and the butter to melt down, or what do you call, melt quickly. And then I'll turn the heat down as I saute the vegetables. So let's go ahead and get the butter in there. We'll get that in there as well. And we'll start to let that melt. I do have my fire on high. And I can see that the coconut oil is starting to bubble a little bit. So we're now gonna turn that down to a 5. And 5.5. So now we're gonna get the onion and the squash, the zucchini, as well as the broccoli and cauliflower in. So the microwave has turned off. And as you can see, my veggies are steaming. And we're just gonna go ahead and add them in now to the oil. And we'll get those started. And we're gonna add in also the onion and the, let me set me down over here. We're gonna add in the onion and the squash. So let me go grab that. And that goes in right on top. Very easy to make this. And it's very good for you if you like veggies. There go my onions. And we're gonna put in the zucchini. So we're gonna get all that started. And I may have told you in another one of my videos when I cook that I use Lowry's seasoning a lot. I'm not gonna use any of the seasoning because I'm gonna make some Indian flavored vegetables, which I do like. So I do keep, as you can tell, a big container of turmeric in my cooking cupboard. So I'm gonna get my turmeric out and add some of that to the veggies. Just a little bit. Here's my fork. I'm just gonna shake some in there, like so. A little bit more. What I like about turmeric also, not only does it enhance flavors, it gives a just a little sweet taste to things, but it also gives great color. So I do like to work with my turmeric. So we've got the turmeric going here. That's the only spice that I'm gonna put in with these vegetables. And I'm going to cover them with a lid so that they start to get moist, hold the heat in, and the moisture from the heat will start to make the vegetables break down a little bit. So I do like to put a lid on those to let them start to cook down. So let's grab my lid. Some of you who watch my videos are probably much younger than me, hopeful, and some of you may be the same age as me. So with that being said, I entertain myself quite often. Let me blow my nose. Oh, no, he didn't, right on the camera. Oh, yeah, he did. Anyhow, I like to entertain myself. So back in the 70s, there was a cook, Julia Child. So let's let Julia cook. So you'll see here that I have my skillet. And in the skillet, we have an array of vegetables. There they are. Oh, they're looking so lovely. And the smell. Too bad I didn't have any sherry. I could add some sherry to my vegetables. It just makes them so much better. But we won't. So we'll just cook the way we cook. And we put the little lid on to keep them sauteed. Enough of Julia, right? Anyhow, so we're going to let those cook down a little bit. And then I'm going to add two more ingredients. I like to put in there, the only thing I used can in my house. I don't buy canned goods. If it isn't fresh from the market, meaning in the vegetable department or the meat department, I don't buy it. And I look for sales. I buy things on sale. And I'm pretty frugal when it comes to what I pay for food. So anyhow, the only thing that I buy canned is I like this Rotel diced tomatoes and green chilies. I do like that. And I add it to my vegetables a lot when I'm cooking because it gives a really nice flavor. The other thing I add when I'm making my Indian vegetable medley is I add my tiki masala curry sauce. And this is a simmer sauce tiki masala. Now this particular brand is called Patox. It doesn't make any difference which brand you use. I think they're all good. I've tried them all. But so I like to add my tomatoes and let those cook down. And at the very end, I put the tahini sauce. Masala. I do like that because I like Indian vegetables. So I'm going to go ahead and cook this and I'll come back to you just before they're finished and show you the results. All right, let me pick you back up here. These have been sauteing for about 3 minutes and the vegetables are starting to get wetter or breaking down. I'm going to turn the temperature down to 4. On the electric stove. Then I'm now going to add my can of diced tomato and green chili peppers. And then they go. Boy, this is already starting to smell good. The mixture of the veggies and now those tomatoes and the turmeric. The smell is really starting to be very inviting. The onion, it's all smelling very well. While these were sauteing, I'm gonna leave the lid off now for a while and let them continue. While these were sauteing, I went ahead and started the second part of our dinner, which is also going to be these thick cut pork chops. There's only one little bone in them. And I get those at the deli case at the market at $5.19 a pound. And these are about a pound and a half, so just a little over. I believe it was like $8.20 for these two pork chops, which are really great for two people for dinner. So the total cost of this dinner is less than $15 for two people. You can't eat, oh look at that hair, you can't eat that cheap in a restaurant, nor that good flavor. I've also turned on my air fryer, which we use a lot, nightly. So it's now preheating for 15 minutes at 425, and then I'll put my pork chops in and they'll take about 10 minutes to cook. And by that time, the veggies should be done. So I'm going to continue to cook and I'm gonna get back with you in just a few minutes, okay? Don't go away. So as you can see, the vegetables have cooked down very nicely and they're steaming quite well. And I still have them on a temperature of 4. What I'm gonna do now is I'm going to go ahead and put in my tiki masala sauce, which is an Indian spice sauce. If you've never used it, I invite you to do so. I've used it now, this jar. This is my third meal, and I still have some left in there for another evening when I make vegetables. So I'm now gonna stir this up in there and mix it up quite well. Oh, I wish you could smell this. The smells are amazing. And it's starting to look the way it's supposed to. Indian vegetables. It looks really wonderful. So we do eat veggies and a piece of meat every day, and we only eat once a day. We eat usually by about 6 o'clock in the evening, and then we don't eat until 6 o'clock the next day. So we go anywhere from 18 to 24 hours without eating. We fast. We drink lots of water. We have our coffee, but you learn in the fasting that you don't get as hungry, and that's how we've done the keto diet and how we've lost our weight. While I had you away, I had my air fryer warming up and preheating for 15 minutes, and now that it's beeping, it's done. So it's ready to put in the pork chops that we're gonna have for dinner. So as you can see, I've got them right here and ready to go. I have spiced them with butter. It says that you should use some type of spray oil when you cook. I just don't like spray oils because, again, you have a chemical in that bottle that's making that olive oil dispense out the top. So you're gonna take your grill out. It's already hot. It's heated up during the process. So as you can see, I've got it out and it's laying right here. And the pork chops are now going to go on it. All right, so there they go. Don't know if you can hear it sizzling. And I've got them spiced really nicely, the two pork chops. And they'll take about 8 minutes. I love my air fryer. I can't tell you how excited I am about our air fryer. Now, I've spiced these with rosemary here, butter, and Montreal steak sauce. I've got the pork chops on there. I'm now going to put the probe in there. And the probe is going to tell me when it reaches the temperature that it's supposed to be at, so the pork chops are done. So the probe's gonna go inside all the way through. You're gonna put this in the air fryer all the way up to the top rack. Close it up. You're gonna then set your timer or set your temperature again for 400 degrees is what you do. So I'm gonna cook it at 400 degrees and now I'm gonna plug in my probe and I'm gonna hit start. And it's gonna start the temperature at 400. I'm now going to push my probe, and when my probe reaches 165 degrees, the pork chops will be done. Right now, it is at about 128. So it's gonna take about 8 to 10 minutes. Back to the veggies. They're looking good. And again, I hope someday that they invent photography with smell. Wouldn't that be wonderful? So you can smell how good these vegetables truly are. Now that I've got them cooked the way I want, I'm gonna turn them all the way down to low, which is the lowest my stove goes, to low. And I'm gonna put the lid back on, and they're gonna just sit there and stay warm until it's time for dinner. So, and now that I got the vegetables back covered and they're simmering on low, I'm going to go back to getting the table set. And when the pork chops are finished, we'll be back with you in a moment, so don't go away. So it's been a few minutes, about 10 minutes since those pork steaks started to cook in the air fryer, and they've now finished, and I'm gonna take it out and we'll do dinner. Look how wonderful that looks. Cooks up very nicely. It's really a nice cut for the money, and really is a nice nice piece to serve with dinner. So there's the vegetables and the pork chop and dinner for under $15 for two people and less than an hour to cook. Bon appetit.